Hi, I'm Norman Wildberger, and today we're going to discuss more about the cross ratio. The cross ratio is defined for four points on a line, and it's a projective quantity. We describe it in terms of affine geometry, in terms of vectors. So we say that the cross ratio between AB and CD, written like this, is by definition the ratio of the vectors AC to AD, which is a number, divided by the ratio of the vectors BC to BD. In this example here, AC to AD is roughly 1:3, so that first ratio would be 1/3. While BC to BD is in this case also 1/3, but it's a minus 1/3 because BC is in the opposite direction to BD. So in this case, the ratio of these two ratios is minus 1. When four points have a cross ratio of minus 1, then they are called a harmonic range. So we say that the four points in order A, B, C, D form a harmonic range when the cross ratio is minus 1. Last time we saw that the projective invariance of the cross ratio could be described the following way. If we have some external point O and lines A, B, C, D to our four points, then the cross ratio is unchanged if we change this line to another line intersecting these four lines here in four new points. So that means that the cross ratio is not just associated to these four points, but actually associated to these four lines. And so it makes sense to talk about the cross ratio of these four lines as being exactly the same as the cross ratio of these four points. So we have some flexibility. We could talk about four points, collinear points, having a cross ratio, or four concurrent lines as having a cross ratio. So in a similar way, we can say that if we have four lines, A, B, C, D, and their cross ratio, which is defined exactly this way to be the cross ratio of the corresponding four points, that's a harmonic pencil if that cross ratio is equal to minus 1. So this would be an example of a harmonic pencil of lines because the cross ratio of those four lines is minus 1. And I also recall that from last time, that if you square the cross ratio, then that can be explicitly described in terms of spreads formed between these four lines. And it turned out to be the spread between lines A and C divided by the spread between A and D, all divided by the spread BC divided by the spread BD. So this ratio spreads divided by this ratio spreads. And this is a much preferable way of thinking rather than through angles and sines, which is the usual treatment of exactly the same phenomena. This is much preferable because it's much more elementary. Spreads are much more elementary than sines. And secondly, it's valid over a general field, even one where sines and angles make no sense. Now let me mention a few things about what happens to the cross ratio when we interchange the order of the points. So suppose we have four points A, B, C, D with this cross ratio, defined by AC over AD divided by BC over BD, equal to some number K. And it will be useful in calculation to imagine that these four points may be, for example, on the x-axis with coordinates A, B, C, D, little a, B, C, D, in which case the cross ratio can be described by this ratio of ratios of numbers. These are just the ordinary x-coordinates of the four points. So we'll suppose that that cross ratio is K. First, what happens if we interchange C and D? Well, if we interchange C and D, then this pair inverts and this pair inverts. So the entire ratio inverts and we get 1 over K instead. What if we interchange A and B? If we interchange A and B, then this ratio here becomes exactly this ratio, and this one becomes this ratio. So again, the ratio of ratios inverts, and we get 1 over k. If we do both of these interchanges, so we interchange A and B and interchange D and C, then we get BA DC, and that's going to then be back to K. And I'll leave it to you to check that also if you interchange A, B, and C, D in this fashion, you also get back to K. Somewhat more interesting is what happens when you interchange B and C. Right. So then it's a nice exercise to take this expression and interchange the B and the C and show that what you get is 1 minus K. So then it turns out that these ways of interchanging our points generates all possible combinations. And we get altogether 6 different possible different cross ratios arising from the original 1K. The original 1K together with 1 over K, 1 minus K, 1 minus 1 over K, which is the same as K minus 1 over K, 1 over 1 minus K, and K over K minus 1. So these are the 6 possible cross ratios you get by taking any 4 collinear points and considering cross ratios in all possible orders. It's a rather interesting set of transformations. Here's another rather interesting formula that deals with a pencil of 4 lines. So in our usual XY plane, suppose we have lines A, B, C, and D all going through the origin, so they're concurrent. And suppose that we've chosen a vector A in this direction, a vector B in this direction, C in this direction, and a vector D in this direction. So A and B form a basis for the space. That means that any other vector can be written as a linear combination of those. So suppose that C is alpha A plus beta B for some numbers alpha and beta. And suppose that the vector D can be written as a combination gamma A plus delta B. Then it's also a nice calculation that the cross ratio of these 4 lines, A, B, C, D, is then a ratio of these ratios, beta to alpha divided by delta to gamma. That's a very simple, elegant formula for the cross ratio of 4 lines when 2 of them are expressed in terms of the other 2. And there's a very important special case of this. The simplest possible special case is when C is actually just the sum of A and B, and D is the difference between A and B. In that case, these ratios beta to alpha is 1 in this case, and over here, delta to gamma is minus 1. So the cross ratio becomes minus 1. In other words, it's a harmonic pencil. So here's a picture. Suppose there's any vector A, there's a vector B. Then there will be A plus B, and there will be A minus B. And then these 4 lines form a harmonic pencil. And I remind you, that means, or has the implication, that for any other line that intersects those 4 lines, gives you automatically a harmonic range of points. This notion of harmonic range and harmonic pencil has also a lovely connection with quadrilaterals and quadrangles. Next time, we're going to talk all about that. I hope you'll join me. I'm Norman Wildberger, and thanks for listening.